Welcome to all. In this video we will discuss about module 3 and the topic is integral calculus and evaluation of double integral. So in this video we will discuss how to evaluate double integral and also how to find the changing order of the integration. Okay, so let's move the problem. So the first problem, type 1, evaluation over the given region. Yeah, this is the type 1. Next one, changing order. So evaluate double integral xy into x plus y into dy dx taken over the area between y equal to x square and y equal to x. So there are, this is the double integral and clearly this is dy, so this is the y limit, and next one this is the dx, so this is the x limit. So this is the x limit and this is the y limit. So what is the y limit? Y limit is x square to x. So one is x square to x. Next we have to find the what is the x limit. So y equal to x square and y equal to x. Now so y equal to x square, another one is y equal to x, therefore x equal to x square is equal. So x square equal to x, or this is x square minus x equal to 0. Taking x outside, we'll get x into x minus 1 equal to 0. So there are two type of solution. One is x equal to 0, another one is x equal to 1. So x limit is 0 to 1 and y limit is x square to x. Okay. So x limit is x square to x, y limit, and x limit is 0 to 1. So and that function multiply inside, we'll get x square y plus x square y square into dy to dx. So first integrate with respect to y each and every term. So x equal to 0 to 1, this is integrate with respect to y, y square by 2 plus x into, this is integrate with respect to y, y cube divided by 3. So upper limit and here lower limit, and here also upper limit and lower limit. So substitute, replace, just to replace y equal to x upper limit, y equal to x square lower limit, and also here. Okay, so first one we'll get x power 4 by 2 minus x square by 2. So this is upper limit minus lower limit plus second function upper limit minus lower limit. Okay, then next one, in each and every term integrate with respect to x. So x power 4 integration is x power 5 divided by 5, 5 into 2, 10. And this is x power 7 divided by 7, 7 into 2, 14. And this one x power 5 divided by 5, that is 15 into 3 into 5, we'll get 15. And this one x power 8 divided by 8, 3 into 8, 24. So substitute upper limit minus lower limit. So just to replace x equal to 1, that is the upper limit, and x equal to 0, that is the lower limit. So upper limit 1 divided by 10 minus 1 divided by 14 plus 1 divided by 15 minus 1 divided by 24. Taking LCM, we'll get simplification is 3 by 56. So this is the area of the region, 3 by 56. Okay. So if the limit is not given, means we have, by using given limit, we have to find the remaining limits. Okay, that is the one. Next one, type 2, evaluation of double integral by changing the order of integration. So why we choose this method, means why we choose this method? So some kind of integration we can't solve ordinary method, so that type of problem easily we have to identify the solution by using changing order of integration. That changing order of integration is two type, one is Cartesian form, another one is polar form. So given the function to convert to Cartesian form and given the problem to convert polar form. So this is also we used, why we used means easily we get the solution. See, sometime the double integral which is difficult to evaluate in the existing form because easy for evaluation changing the order of integration. So sometimes some type of integral, double integral, we can't solve the normal method, ordinary integration is not possible to getting the solution. So that type of solution easily we have to evaluate by using changing the order of integration. That is the main use or main application of the changing order of integration. For first problem, change the order of integration and hence evaluate 0 to 4a x square by 4a 2 root ax xy dy dx. So this, if you possible, means you can solve this problem. Okay, it is very difficult, but it is not possible. So this type of problem we can solve by the changing order of integration. So read the question carefully. Changing order of the integration and hence evaluate. So if changing order of integration means we can convert to changing order of integration is nothing, dy dx we have to convert to, we have to change dx dy, that is changing order of integration by the Cartesian form. In case polar form means dy dx we can convert to r into dr d theta. Okay, dr d theta. So this is dy dx, we can convert to dx dy, and also we have to interchange the limit. We have to find the limit of x limit and y limit. So clearly this is, here is the y limit and this one is the x limit. X limit is constant 0 to 4a. So take given the function I equal to, next we have to find the limits. So x square by 4a equal to 2 into root ax, this is the y limit, y equal to y, so cross multiplication and squaring on both sides, we'll get x power 4. This is 2ax, and taking opposite direction, we'll get x power 4, 64a cube x. So this is, taking x outside, we'll get x cube minus 64a cube equal to 0. So we'll get the solution is x equal to 0 and x equal to 4a. So this is the x limit, x equal to 0, x equal to 4a. So what is the y limit? If you substitute x equal to 0, we'll get y equal to 0 and y equal to 4a. So by using this limit, we'll get y equal to 0 and y equal to 4a. And on another point, the point of intersection of the parabolas y equal to x square by 4a and y equal to 2 root ax, are point is 0 comma 0 and 4a comma 4a, because x equal to 0, y equal to 0, x equal to 4a, y equal to 4a. So the changing order of integration, we have y varies from 0 to 4a and x varies from, you have to find x. So y square divided by 4a, that is y equal to 2 into root ax to 2 root ay, that is x square by 4a. So x varies from y square by 4a to 2 root ay. So the changing order of integration, I equal to y limit 0 to 4a and x limit y square by 4a to 2 root ay xy dx dy. So given the function is dy dx, we convert to dx dy. So y equal to 0 to 4a, integrate with respect to x, we'll get x square by 2 y square by 4a 2 root ay into dy. So substitute upper limit minus lower limit. So this is the upper limit minus this is the lower limit. Okay, and next one, integrate with respect to y. So we'll get y square by 2, here y power 5 divided by 5. So we'll multiply y inside, this is y square and this one is y power 5. So y square means we'll get y cube divided by 3, and y power 5 means we'll get y power 6 divided by 6. So y equal to substitute upper limit minus lower limit. So that is 4a upper limit minus second one, this one, minus lower limit is 0. Okay, so this one, 1 by 2, 256 a power 4 divided by 3 minus 128 a power 4 divided by 3. So base are equal, adding the power, we'll get 128, 1 by 2 into 128 a power 4 divided by 3. So that is 128 means we'll get 64. So 64 a power 4 by 3. So this is the solution. So by using changing order of integration, easily we have to evaluate given the solution. Some type of problem is not possible to getting direct solution, so that type of problem easily we solved by using changing order of integration. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you are all understand how to evaluate double integral by changing order of integration in the Cartesian form. Next video we'll discuss in the polar form. Okay, so thank you to all.